Eastern Wrestling Federation, Castle Hill Ballroom, Bethlehem, PA. Even though the date's at October 1st, Third Degree, it's Halloween tonight, my friend.
You're right.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Castle Hill Ballroom. Wrestling fans, welcome to the Eastern Wrestling Federation. Tonight's event is under the auspices of PCK Promotions, promoted solely by BC Bumps Incorporated. Tonight, you will see top quality professional wrestling brought to you by the superstars of the EWF.
Man, oh man, are you ready, Third Degree? What a night of wrestling here with the Eastern Wrestling Federation.
This music can only mean one thing. There we go, baby!
What a win! What a way to kick it off. Here comes the Pack. Oh, my God, and they're involved in a big main event tonight. They look like they are ready.
Bad True Tuesday, Danny Rose, and John Cronin. The Pack has never been any stronger than tonight.
I believe that the Pack invented Cage Terror. Last year was a big success. They went over big, and now we're back. Cage Terror 2, and they're here, and I believe I have this funny feeling that someone's gonna get hurt tonight. Looks like the Pack has something to say to kick off this big night of wrestling with the Eastern Wrestling Federation, baby.
Castle Hill Ballroom, how the hell you do tonight? I got a little something I wanna talk about first before we get rolling here. You can pick up a newsletter. You don't got those newsletters here tonight? You don't? Well, can I talk about it anyway? There's a newsletter that Bud Carson does, and there's an article in it. The title of it is EWO by the Gate Master Savage. And if anybody wants to know who the hell that is, he's the guy with the cane, and he's sitting right there.
He's my favorite troll, RC.
Are you glad you're in the spotlight at Cage Terror, huh? Sit your ass down. I'm gonna hit the highlighted points of his paragraph, which talks about Bad True and the EWF. First off, EWO. Let me tell you something. Right off the top, there's some originality for you.
I think he's being sarcastic.
Then he states that he's been to some excellent WXW events and some good EWF shows. And besides that, we have a working relationship with WXW. And let me tell you this, we don't play that competition game of who is better. We simply work together to keep independent professional wrestling on the map here in the Lehigh Valley.
Amen.
That's the way it should be.
I agree. I think they should kick that guy out.
Then he says, Jake and Paul, of course, Bad Crew can't take a joke. Wrong, because we like a good joke every now and then, and what is going on here is not a joke. It's simply a professionally run organization. The only joke that's here tonight is in the crowd, and it's sitting in your damn seat.
Oh my!
Oh baby!
Look out! Put him in the cage!
Does Jake have a gun? Because I think
there's
a shoot.
Here's another one. He says Bad Crew has a problem with the pit bulls. It's not us that has the problem with the pit bulls. I think it's the people that have a problem with the pit bulls, because every time they're booked in this building, we've had the worst damn crowds ever. My dogs of war. Your dogs of war? Damn, are you a freaking mark?
a nail on the head there, RC.
You think the Pitbulls give a shit about you? No, to them and to everybody else here, you're simply a jabroni. Then you say the Pitbulls are just too good for the bad crew. I'll answer that with one simple question. Who has a very successful professional wrestling training center and who doesn't?
It's very rare I agree with the Pack, but I have to give the nod for the Pack for this one.
Then you say I don't think Bad Crew wants another ass whooping like they received in a dog collar match on August 29th, 1998 from the Pitbulls. Well, in your last paragraph in that silly article, you talked about how you were smart and you weren't a mark. Well, if you're so damn smart, you know this sports entertainment business is a work.
Shot number two.
Now, about that silly ass sign you got floating around here, Bad Crew fears the Pit Bulls. I don't care what kind of sign you got. You can write whatever the hell you want. And as far as us being testy, the only thing testy here is the lack of your testes after we kick them up into your throat.
There you go. There you go, baby.
And now, Cage Terror, Hungarian Barbarian, Adam Flash, Sal.
Got glasses.
They're very
First
stylish.
Of all, nice gloves. Second of all, as if you didn't know, I am Doomsday Danny Rose. This is the Bad Crew, Eliminator Cronin. Brother, we are the Pack. Boys, in the back, you want some? Come get some. You know we're gonna
cage match?
Tell him, baby!
Let's get on with the show here tonight.
Why are you interrupting?
Hit the music!
There you go, baby, the Pack. In full force here in the EWF. Cage Terror 2. They're gonna...
It's not a steel cage match. It is a barbed wire steel cage match tonight. Not one, but two events inside the barbed wire steel cage. My God, you have a piece of wrestling history in your VCR. And I'll tell you, I'm excited to be here. Not necessarily with you, but what can I do?
You can do your job.
Good evening,
stop
me. Town.
Say a few prayers before the Knights of Beds.
Will you please? RC with third degree burns ringside.
How's everybody been? Great! I like to hear that.
Thank you, Father.
He is your ring announcer.
I'd like to welcome everyone here to Castle Hill Ballroom. Tonight, the EWF presents a great night of professional wrestling. And as you heard earlier, this is the night for Cage Terror 2. After tonight's action, ladies and gentlemen, you'll be able to meet lots of the EWF wrestlers at the Hampton Lanes.
A few technical problems here.
Third degree, a lot of questions we have to talk about tonight. A lot of events happening. Tiny out of the Pack.
There we are. Directions to the Hampton Lane.
Pack doesn't need
to be got at the ticket table. The next show here will be on Friday, November the 19th, and it will be featuring the Bushwhackers. Also, the week preceding that on the 12th, EWF will be at the Garfield on Main Street in Northampton. Information about that a little later. Tickets will be on sale currently. Your referees for tonight's action are Marv Pee Wee Yo and Brian Logan. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Spang, and with no further ado, let's get ready for wrestling!
How can you say
this is our first contest
that
of the
pack doesn't need tiny?
It has
the
a
pack
1 minute
doesn't
time
need tiny
with one fall.
It's that simple.
We'll talk about that more. Let's get set for our first event coming out to the ring. Man, what a night of wrestling. We're going to have a dance-off here tonight. A dance-off.
Love bugging Jimmy Dio.
Legendary.
I can't wait.
Legendary Jimmy Dio.
Here we go. It's Mercury coming to the ring. He's set to face off against Samoan Storm, Offa Jr.
A lot of great things out of Offa Jr., the Samoan Storm. This should be a great way to kick off Cage Terror 2. Tiny, he's here in action tonight, and I'm sure he'll be watching the pack very closely.
You're probably right. I can't disagree with you on that point.
Samoan Storm coming down to the ring. EWF has been turning heads all over the independent scene. And we're glad to be here, baby.
Offering only the best in professional wrestling. Every time I see Offa Jr., he gets better and better each week.
Should be a great match, great test right here for both wrestlers, both Mercury and Offa Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce the combatants. First, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, he weighs 205 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, Kid Mercury!
Not a favorite here in the EWF.
What do these fans want?
And his opponent hails from Allentown, Pennsylvania, and he weighs in at an even 200 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, Offa Jr., the Samoan Storm!
They obviously like the local guy from Allentown, right here, close by Bethlehem.
I'll give Offa Jr. his props. He's a good wrestler, but he's like all the other Samoans, cheaters.
That's ridiculous. You're just saying that because they're not here right now. If they were here, you wouldn't say that. I know you.
I'd say it right to...
Oh.
Maybe not.
I'll tell you what, I'll tell Offa Jr. on his way back here, I'll tell him exactly what you said. Here we go, we lock up. Mercury already resorting to illegal tactics.
Get to the count of five.
I see how this night's gonna go. So far, two moves and they've both been illegal.
It's a legal choke for 4 seconds.
Beautiful. I'm not even gonna argue this point with you. Has him in the corner now. Whips him in.
Those close fist illegal.
Beautiful move. Oh, what a move by Mercury.
Nice drop kick right to the throat there.
So far, Offa Jr. really hasn't got it going now. Whips him into the ropes, comes off.
Big leg lariat by Mercury.
No way, too soon.
He's gotta hook the leg. I'm gonna say it once tonight and that's all I'm gonna say.
Even then it was too soon. Mercury already going up. Send him up on the top turnbuckle. Soften him up. That's a dangerous place to be. You better... Oh! Good God, that's it. It's over. One, two. Then, oh! It could have been over with one move.
He's not going to beat Mercury with a big power bomb like that.
Well, how could Mercury go up to the top and waste time like that? You got to get up there and get the job done.
It's all in his strategy.
Oh, okay.
Mercury's a thinking man's wrestler.
Leg drop by Offa Jr. for the pin now. One, two. Now, I can get him that way, that's for sure. Not with a leg drop.
What's Samoan Storm thinking? You can't beat him with a leg drop. There's no way. Reversal.
Oh, what a great DDT. Oh, man. I thought he had him.
Samoan Storm showing his inexperience
by not hooking that famous leg.
I'm glad you picked up on it.
And we know all the ring wars you've had, that's for sure. Oh, no, that didn't work.
Oh,
my God, and wrestling fans, there are no mats down here at the Castle Hill Ballroom.
Do you have a spatula?
Oh.
Snow shovel?
That sounded horrible. I don't know if Alpha Jr. can get back into the ring. Now the fans trying to rally behind Alpha Jr., trying to get him up. But that kind of a drop that he had, my God, I can't believe he's getting up that quickly. Mercury there to meet him. He's going to bring him in the hard way. Suplex him in. Beautiful move by Mercury. Oh, what a pin.
In the pin. He can have him here.
No way. No way.
I wish Alpha Jr. would save up a little money and buy a pair of wrestling boots.
This match, so important to both wrestlers.
Whoever the winner is has a good shot at going for the EWF light heavyweight title.
Yes, that'll be here. Big matchup later on. That has been very hot and heavy, that contest. Look at this maneuver. Oh, but he backfired. Looked good on paper, but didn't pay off.
You're right. It looked very pretty, but Alpha Jr. just not dazed. Knowing where he's at in the ring.
You want to do a move like that? My God. You make sure Alpha Jr. Alpha Jr. laying in with those chops in the turnbuckle.
What'd he do? Chop down trees with his bare hand?
He probably could. And if that doesn't work, I'm sure he can headbutt them down. No. Referee, wrong place, wrong time.
Poor Brian Logan.
I can't. Now, this is a terrible way for this to happen. Oh, he has him. He has him. Alpha Jr. has him. But there's no referee. There's no referee. Oh, the referee's down. What is this now? We've seen this before. Wait a minute. What the hell? What the hell?
Trent Acid, he's the man.
Trent, where did he go?
A long feud here. Trent Acid and Alpha Jr.
Oh, no. Oh, that's horrible.
Mercury's the winner. I told you.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I told you Mercury would win.
35 seconds. The winner.
With that win.
The ref didn't see it, so I didn't see it.
I hope he's going to go back and give half of his pay to Trent Acid for the assist. You've seen this like I saw it. Trent Acid with a chair to the back.
What are you talking about?
I tell you, I don't want to be Trent Acid right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, the second contest of the evening has a 20-minute time limit with one fall. And the marvelous Marv Pirio, referee.
Here we go in our second match. Already controversy here in the EWF. Third degree, stop celebrating.
Woo-hoo!
With Mercury. Get over here and do your job.
Another one of my favorites.
Oh, I can tell. That's a lovely boa. Straight from Jesse Ventura's closet, I'm sure.
Stone Cold Ted Austin. He's a master of originality.
I can tell. Oh, what is he trying? Maybe he should be in the dance-off later on.
Dance contest.
Thank God. Thank God for that. wait until Mr. Chad Austin sees what is coming out right now. His dancing will stop immediately.
No matter how big his opponent is, Chad Austin will defeat him.
No way, look at the, here comes the monster down the ringside. Oh my God, Jake Daniels, look at him, please.
Jake Daniels doesn't have a shot.
Look at
defeating Chad Austin.
Look at the shape Jake Daniels is in lately. My God, he must have lost over 100 pounds, looking better than he's ever had.
He still has no shot in defeating Chad Austin.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce
Chad Austin has the height advantage, the speed advantage, the strength advantage, the weight advantage.
Could I ask what is in your lemonade?
Skinnier neck kid in the front row. He's not a skinny, bigger neck kid. And he's much skinnier than somebody else.
Well, will Chad Austin let the ring announcer do the job here?
Ladies and gentlemen, Chad Austin!
Jake Daniels is a no-nonsense fella. I've known this guy personally. Very devastating in the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent weighs 290 pounds. Hey, hails from Johnstown, Pennsylvania. Jonestown, Pennsylvania. Ladies and gentlemen, Jake Daniels.
Chad Austin victorious.
Is that your prediction?
I'm predicting it.
Okay, good. I'll mark that down.
I'm one for one already.
Now, old Chad Austin, this is just, he is just trying to stall because look what's across from him in the ring. Jake Daniels, I'd stall too.
Psychology, RC. It's all about the psychological game.
Here goes the bell. All of a sudden, the psychology's over. And now it's time for Chad Austin to step up to the plate and see if he can go with the big man. I'm hoping that they get Jake Daniels' ring gear out of the ring. My God, those spikes are still on the apron.
I think Chad Austin will defeat him in less than a minute.
What is Chad Austin trying to do? What?
Jake Daniels isn't... If I was Jake Daniels, I'd lay down, take the loser's pay and go home with...
Okay. Not even give it a chance, right?
Not even give it a chance.
Yeah, you're right.
He doesn't want to get hurt.
Oh, okay. I can tell. I mean, look at him. Chad Austin, he's stacked, baby. He is stacked.
He's chiseled cutting jack.
Oh, I can tell.
Chad Austin is all natural.
You're right about that. All natural of nothing. There's nothing to him. Oh. Come on, that's Jake Daniels.
Those devastating blows,
yeah,
by Austin.
Austin whips him in. What's he trying to do?
Oh, he was hitting a power slam.
That's how you do a power slam. Thank you, Chad Austin. Hello. Yeah, I thought so. Exit stage right. Who should lay down?
Chad Austin wanted to test the strength of Jake Daniels.
Well, I hope he got his test. Obviously, Jake could probably put him through the ceiling if he wanted to. Instead of jaw-jacking to Homer or ringside, get in the ring and prove yourself.
He can easily do the same thing to Jake Daniels. Probably with one hand.
Want to put a little wager on that?
I'll bet you a cinnamon roll.
Anyway, I've worked with some winners, but you take the prize so far. Chad Austin suckering Jake Daniels in again. Now, I don't understand. Chad Austin seems to be,
nice,
he's distracted very well.
Look at him dance.
You know what? Thank you, Jake Daniels. I think I could pin Chad Austin.
If you sat on him, maybe.
Enough of that. Jake Mike Daniels laying in the kicks.
No, those kicks are illegal.
He has five. He has 5 seconds, right? Mr. Excuses. That didn't work out. Sets him up. Nice! Belly to back suplex. Austin Bagging off. What a shock.
He has him right where he wants.
Yeah, you can take him on any time, right?
Uh-oh, setting up for a pump handle.
Oh, my God! He almost put him in the third row.
If that rope wasn't there, he probably would have landed in the third row.
So far, it looks like I'm getting that cinnamon bun, huh? Picks him up. No problem at all. There you go.
That backbreaker's illegal.
Cancel that chiropractor session you had. He just gave it to you for free. Jake Daniels setting him up. Uh-oh. I think it's a one-way ticket.
Yay! I told you.
Chad Austin with a cheap shot, rake of the eyes. That'll break anything, that's for sure. Veteran referee Pee-wee Yo is in the ring. We're in good hands.
That poke to the eyes is perfectly legal.
I know. And he has 5 seconds here, I know. Good God. Whips him in. Oh, here we go. Take two. One way. Oh, my.
Told you.
Jake Daniels.
Strength advantage.
He has to obviously have Chad Austin worn down. He hurt his hand on Jake Daniels' head. Puts him in. Then a turnbuckle. See, there's too much. He's distracted too easily by the crowd.
He doesn't need to concentrate on Jake Daniels.
Oh, what are you talking about? Jake Daniels is a veteran, even though he's only been in the business for a short while. Oh, he took him out of his boots almost with that clothesline. If I'm Chad Austin, I want to end this match as soon as possible.
What are you talking about?
Well, look at him in there. He's getting pummeled. Jake Daniels wearing down Chad Austin.
This is like Rocky. Chad Austin's like Rocky. Taking everything Jake Daniels has to offer to wear him down.
Oh, God. I'm glad you brought Stallone into it. Thank you. Chad Austin now saying he's going up top. Take your time, Chad. Not really. Take your time. Don't worry about it. Take three. Is it? No, he's gonna choke slam him. Off the turnbuckle, oh my God! That's it.
Chad, kick out!
Please. I'll take that cinnamon bun, buddy. Big win by Jake Daniels.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 minutes and 35 seconds, new winner, Jake
here to spoil the party.
It's the White Abdullah.
Oh my God. Look out, Jake Daniels. Oh. Jake Daniels, I can't believe this. Oh, whoever that is just got nailed. But I'm afraid Jake Daniels is gonna get, did you hear that crack?
Jake Daniels deserved it.
Now who the hell, what is gonna happen? Oh, I think Abdullah has a twin brother from an illegitimate father. Here he comes off again with a big elbow. We need some help down here for Jake Daniels. He just wrestled the match. Could someone stop this? Oh! Jake Daniels, his sternum has to be crushed. Not again! What is the reason for this?
Wow, did you see what the big man did? Well, Jake, we gave you time. You wanted to be a Valentine's Day, didn't you? Brother, because I got a surprise for everybody here tonight. I'm going to be
T-shirt once.
Right here.
A fair warning for everybody. A new stable, and that's the first guy.
The Butcher.
Things are looking pretty good with the Butcher. Look at him. Look at him.
Butcher looks more like a baker and a candlestick maker.
All of them rolled up on another elbow, please.
Bye-bye, Jake Daniels.
Just remember, it took two of them. Well, actually, three of them. The Butcher is an awesome, awesome individual. Tell. Invite him over for Sunday dinner, maybe?
Maybe. I won't invite you.
I know you won't. Not that I would accept, but...
Before we go any further, once again, ladies and gentlemen, you can meet the EWF stars tonight, later, at Hampton Lanes. And once again, directions to Hampton Lanes are available at the ticket stand.
We saw the pack.
The next match,
Doomsday Danny Rose, is that shoulder 100%? 100%.
1 minute time limit.
We'll find out later on.
Oh! Trent Acid, one of my favorites.
We've seen this guy once already tonight.
He gave Austin Jr. what he deserved. A beat with a chair.
I love your reasoning.
Those Samoans need discipline in their life.
Next time, I hope you pick better seats. Right by the speakers here, baby. Can you pay for the better seat?
Como estas? Por favor.
Trent Acid against Ty Street. So far, Cage Terror 2 at the EWF has been unbelievable. Things happening left and right, and that's what you get with the Eastern Wrestling Federation. You don't know what to expect.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is bundle number 5.
One of your favorite songs.
Sing it with me.
This is by Lou. I'm begging you, Vega.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
No, don't sing, please.
Here he comes, Johnny Cashmere.
Big fan favorite with the women, it sounds like.
He's one half of the Cashmerian. Trent Acid is set to wrestle Ty Street tonight. However, Ty Street was unable to make it. He's got a good opponent here in Johnny Cashmere. There's no doubt in it.
All righty. I'm sure you have a reason why Ty Street couldn't make it. Because you're good friends with him, right?
I don't know why he didn't make it.
I thought you knew everything.
Philly, Texas, and he claims the weigh in at 9 1/2 inches.
Oh, come on!
Ladies and gentlemen,
he's not over-exaggerating at all.
Hassan!
Please. That is unnecessary.
And his opponent,
big fan favorite, Hales
from New York City.
I could tell.
And he weighs in at 208 pounds. Give it up for Johnny Cashmere!
All righty! If he can wrestle as smooth as he can dance, big victory for Johnny coming up tonight.
Trent's a real good clapper.
No one cares.
I care.
No one cares that he could clap.
Johnny Cashmere's a punk.
Okay.
Did you hear that music selection?
I think everyone loved the music here.
I'm surprised he didn't come after the Backstreet
now,
Boys.
What is this now?
Degrees.
Why is Mr. Trent Acid, Mr. Chair Wheelie Trent Acid leaving?
He didn't use a chair.
Oh. Okay.
Did you view it?
Yeah, I was watching the same thing that you were watching when he came on the first match.
It wasn't on my monitor.
I was waiting for that one. Man, you're pulling them all out, aren't you? What do you do on Monday nights? I can't tell. Now maybe Mr. Acid's ready to wrestle. They lock up. Nice. Beautiful.
Phenomenal.
That was such a great move, the Showboat. I'm all for it.
That's what you call wrestling, Colin!
All righty. I recommend that Trent does not run for mayor anytime soon in the beautiful suburb of Bethlehem.
He's a native of Texas. How could he?
You're right. Lock up again. Arm drag takedown. There you go. High risk anywhere in America, that move is.
Trent Acid's all about one thing, wrestling.
I could tell. He's doing a lot of it so far. If this tempo keeps up, it could be a long match.
If the fans gave him any kind of respect, he wouldn't have to do this.
That's what you're here for. You respect him. I think the fans are actually starting to question his sexuality. Would you like to maybe comment on his sexuality? Huh? Huh? Yeah. Okay.
I had something in my mouth.
Side headlock. It's been a while since I saw one of those in wrestling. Whips him in. Beautiful shoulder block down. Some bad mouthing over him. Comes across. Ducks the elbow. Boot to the stomach, puts him over.
There's the hip toss he's looking for.
Beautiful arm drag. No showboating on his part, picks him up. Nice body slam. Comes off, beautiful clothesline. Couldn't get him over. Drop kick, that sends him through. Trent Acid is down.
Trent Acid just buying some time.
He should. If I was Trent Acid, I'd buy time too.
What a cheater like Johnny Cashmere.
But it doesn't
rethink your game plan.
It doesn't look like it's a plan that he wanted to. He was forced out of the ring. And now he's leaving to go back to the locker room. What is this all about? But here comes Johnny. Here he comes. And he's going to put him right back. And good for him.
I thought they were going to come over by us.
You better protect us if they do. You're my protector. Johnny now has him up. He put the shots in. One, two, laying them in. Bethlehem counting along with the Eastern Wrestling Federation.
I'm surprised they could.
Beautiful move by Johnny. He reverses.
Beautiful.
And then a turnbuckle catches them all.
Flying hits it.
Beautiful.
Great chain wrestling there.
Johnny sends him in. Couldn't hold on. Reversal, my God. How can he keep up with it? Another boot to the stomach. Another shot into the ropes. And another flying head scissor. So many reversals.
Really not working out for my boy Trent Acid, is it?
You better regroup. Maybe you should do some magic on the side. Through the legs. Ducks a clothesline.
Oh!
He nailed him.
Johnny Cashmere, you better check for your front teeth.
Oh, he nailed him. Referee better check. Poor Johnny, my God.
He won't be kissing any babies after that move.
He nailed him. Here comes Trent Acid. This is not going to be good. It better pay off for Trent. Look out, Johnny. He comes off. Beautiful. It didn't sound good at all.
cameraman Derry Walter getting all the action right up close.
The hardest working camera guy in the indie scene right there, Mr. Gary Walters.
His belt's the hardest working thing in his wardrobe.
Now let's knock it on Gary. He's doing a heck of a job. Back in the ring. And instead of going for the pin, he's choking him?
He's trying to pin him.
You don't pin a guy by choking him.
He was trying to hook the throat.
Yes. Much easier than hooking the leg, I guess. Whips him in. Nice elbow. I really do think if Trent would maybe follow up his big moves, he'd have a chance to pin this young guy. But now, look at that cover. Come on. Now, Trent Acid, such a nonchalant cover like that.
I thought he was pinning him very well.
He would.
Ooh.
Oh, what a shot by Johnny. Working his way back up. Momentum cut off right there with a rake of the eyes. That will do it, my friends. That will do it. In the corner now, referee has to get him out of there. Come on, ref. Is that the same guy that was knocked around the first match? Reversal into the turnbuckle. Trent Acid, nice move, jumps over. Nice.
Shoulder tackle.
He's gonna come in.
Floats over.
Beautiful clothesline duck, here they come. Oh, double clothesline. And you knew that was gonna happen eventually.
Did you hear Cashmere's neck snap?
Just because these two are off the ropes so much, you knew something like that was gonna happen. They're both wrestling each other's style for wrestling, so you knew it was gonna happen, a double clothesline eventually.
These men have wrestled many times before.
They know each other. They know each other. They know their styles. They're probably thinking right now the same thing almost. They both come up at the same time. Trent lands a big one. Johnny goes back.
At his goal. Changing a big close fist.
Back and forth. What a move that was by Johnny.
Big suplex there by Cashmere.
Setting him up now.
Cashmere seems to be down at the top rope.
Up in one shot. Beautiful elbow. Man, oh man.
Kick out, Trent.
Yes, kicks out.
I told you Cashmere couldn't pin him.
All right, okay. I don't see Trent having any successful pins so far either. It's a great match so far. I'll give Trent Acid all the due. Look at it, beautiful.
Open face Russian leg sweep.
Puts him down. Now Trent's calling for it, going for the same turnbuckle. Will it pay off? What a moonsault. Will it pay off for Trent? Why isn't he pinning him? Arrogant son of a... I can't... Oh, wait a minute. What's good for the goose is good for the gander. Oh! Good for Alpha Jr. Good. I don't blame him.
There was no need for that.
And Johnny Kander, 1, 2, and he got him. Beautiful.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Trent Acid would have pinned him if it wasn't for that punk off the Jew.
Seconds. You're the winner from New York City, Johnny Kander.
What's good for the goose is good for the gander, my friend.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Everybody in the car, so come on, let's ride to the liquor store. I want to come down. The boy said he wants some gin and juice.
I hate this song.
Something tells me somewhere down the line, Alpha Jr. and Trent Acid are going to meet in a big way.
They have to. There's no other option.
Hey, it was okay in the first match, but now it's not okay. You're kidding me.
Up next is that cheater, that turncoat.
I want to talk about August 7th. Yeah, August 7th, 1999, right here at Castle Hill Ballroom. The Pack kicked Tiny out of the Pack.
That's the best thing Nick had ever done.
They said they needed a change. You look at Tiny, how can you kick someone like Tiny out of the Pack? He plays a big part of the Pack.
You need a big foot to kick him out.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next show here will be on Friday, November the 19th, and it will be featuring the Bushwhackers. And don't forget the Hampton Lanes right after tonight's action to meet your EWF stars.
One thing I want to look
up. This is the next EWF match of the evening. It has a 20-minute time limit with one fall.
When the whole thing went down with the Pack and Tiny, George Anthony acted like he wasn't for it. I want to watch that very closely. Comes one of your favorites.
Here comes one word, superstar. One of the best looking men in wrestling.
Arrogant, one of the most arrogant stars in the business today. I'll give Bob Starr his due. I will say he's a star. Arrogant though. He's in for a big surprise.
Everybody wants to be like Bob Starr.
Here comes ex-Pac member. Just like the sign says, they knock him down, he gets back up.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce first to you, from Malibu Beach, California, he weighs 235 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, Hollywood Playboy, Bobby Starr!
What?
All the women want him.
Please!
And his opponent hails from Summit Hill, Pennsylvania. He weighs in at 454 pounds.
Man, oh man.
He is the Summit Hill Smasher, Tiny!
Look out, Tiny! Oh!
Well, Bob Starr frequents the Playboy Mansion.
Oh, yeah. And they also throw him out for trespassing. Bob Starr working on, I'll tell you what, mark this down. Bob Starr is actually doing something that I agree with. Work on Tiny's legs. Get those taken out, and then you have a chance against this man. But you better keep on the big man. Tiny has a big, big bullseye on his back.
Bob Starr can easily press slam him.
Yeah, right. Big forearm by Tiny. I'll tell you what, you don't want to mess with...
What are we going to do here?
You don't want to mess with Tiny. He's in a bad mood. I saw him earlier in the locker room. He wasn't even talking to anybody. Big body slam by Tiny. Comes off the ropes. Oh, pulls him over to the clothesline. Yeah, Bob Starr better... Hey, you know what?
Good idea, Bob.
Yeah, you better go back to the locker room too, Bob. Because I don't care. You put anybody in the ring with Tiny, and they won't have a chance because he is just in a foul mood for what the Pack did to him. Don't blame them. How many months was the Pack together? They're like brothers. And they kick off tight. Why? For a change? Maybe they should change their underwear if they want to change.
Best thing the Pack could have did.
Come
get
on.
Rid of Tiny.
Get rid of Tiny. What are you saying? Tiny was the weak link of the Pack? My God, look at him.
There's no doubt he was the weak link.
Oh. You know, it's not even worth talking to you about this. Everyone knows you're a big Pack market. That's all there is to it. Bob Starr with the chops. I don't know if it will. I wouldn't work
he
on the midsection.
Lit him up with those chops.
I wouldn't work on the midsection, that's for sure.
It's gonna take a while. Don't start looking in some of those best
man.
Shape ever.
Oh man, he's gonna get Tiny mad and look out. You know what happens when he got mad. Now's a chance if I Bob Starr, I want to stay on top of the big guy.
The only advantage Tiny has in this match is his criminal history is longer than Bob Starr's.
No reason for the Pack kicking Tiny out. None. No reason for it.
Tiny used to drink all their Gatorade. That's plenty of
reason. I'm not even gonna support this. This is ridiculous. I don't even know why you're bringing all this stuff up.
Tiny was a loosed cannon. They had to get rid of him.
There's no other reason why.
He has some problems, and let it go, all right? Now look at this. Now Bob Starr has a bigger problem. We're going to see what Bob ate for supper tonight. Look out. Off the ropes. Oh, my God. Move.
Woohoo! Bob moved. Bob's a genius.
Nah, I wouldn't go that far.
Look at all the women here in attendance drooling.
Where do you see that?
We get security out here to mop up the floor from all the drool.
Referee Pee-wee Yo, get in there. I think that was in the throat.
The men want to be him. The women want to be with him.
Why are you trying to put over Bob Starr for good? What, does he owe you money or something? I heard he's like that, you know. So far now, Bob Starr is taking control of Tiny the Big Man, whips him in, comes off. Oh, come on. You have a better chance of doing that to a Mack truck, buddy. Tiny off the ropes. No, he misses again. All Tiny has to do is land one of those moves and it's over.
I can't disagree with you.
Not one, folks. Two matches inside the barbed wire steel cage later on tonight. Halloween has come a little early here in the EWF. Tiny now in control, putting Bob Starr, I'm sorry, Hollywood Bob Starr in the ropes. Ha-ha! There's a big elbow! That's it! One, two, oh, he raked the eyes!
That's an easy way to kick out.
Yes, it is. Doesn't take much ambition, quite up Bob Starr's alley.
Bob Starr is one of the most determined wrestlers I've ever met.
Determined for what?
Greatness.
Is that what you call it? Just checking. I'll tell you what, if anything, he really knows how to rake the eyes. He's really had that put down pat.
The Nitro girls are big fans of his.
Collect all the Bob Starr tapes. What a pin. Bob Starr with a pin one. He picks him up. What is he thinking?
He could have had him right there.
What's he thinking? You want to screw with the big man? My God. There you go. There you go. Tiny's upset. He's up. He whips him in. Comes off. He's going to take care of him.
Sidewalk slam.
Now, here we go. Look at the big man.
Bob better move.
Second rope. He has him up. He comes down. Oh! Oh, my God.
I can't deny that.
Minutes and 45 seconds. The Southern Hills Slasher,
Tiny! I hope there's a dumpster nearby.
Yeah, I'm glad to see the Pack kicked him out. Good idea. You want to get rid of Tiny. A big man coming off the second turnbuckle, so agile. Why would you want to kick him out? Incredible. And you sit here and defend that. You're a bigger idiot than they are. And I'll say it to your face. Tiny the Seminole Smasher, he wants revenge.
He just got lucky tonight.
You're right. Hollywood Bob Starr had him right where he wanted him, right?
Speaking about getting lucky tonight, there's no doubt in my mind Bob Starr will get lucky tonight.
I hope. My hotel room isn't by his, because I'll never get any sleep. I guarantee you, you're right. You think maybe he'll let us, you know, maybe get some of the leftovers? I don't think they like you, Bob.
They don't even know him that well.
Ladies and gentlemen,
the owner of a brown Plymouth Voyager, Pennsylvania plate, BJW0512 has their lights on. A brown Plymouth Voyager. You got one of them, your lights are on. If you want to drive home, I suggest
just
you go
turn them
off.
Just be glad your car's not on fire.
Yeah. Here comes our first tag team of the evening.
Our next contest of the evening, ladies and gentlemen, is a tag team match.
The Pack are involved.
It has a 20-minute time limit with one fall.
Very interesting tag team coming up.
One of your favorites, the Rough Riders.
Sweet Daddy J Love, Flex Wheeler. What a great tag team here in the EWF.
Flex Wheeler, one of the most respected men in the business.
Better believe it. He paid his dues.
That's about all he's paid.
And Sweet Daddy J Love also paid his dues. They get this crowd going every time they come out here, baby.
They're going against my team.
Yeah, we know. Do you want to announce who they are?
Dirty Deeds, Darren Weiss.
Beautiful, beautiful guy.
Appeared on Howard Stern.
You're right.
With his wife and his girlfriend.
Oh, yeah.
He's got a maid, brother. And Pinky.
All of a sudden, the heck with Bob Starr, you want to hook up with Darren Weiss,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And Pinky. Here comes members of the Pack. There they are. There they are.
The Pack.
Starting to celebrate a little early. I'll tell you what, Third Degree, we are definitely in Pack territory, my friend.
About time you admit to it.
Hey, say what you want to say about the Pack, they are becoming one of the most feared teams in the business today. I'll give them that too. I think they're all arrogant, son of a...
Let me first introduce to you. He claims to hail from wherever he wants. His weight is unknown. He is Sweet Daddy J Love. And his partner hails from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Weighs in at 210 pounds. He is the ladies' man. Riders! And their opponents, weighing a combined weight of 405 pounds. First, let me introduce you. You've seen him on the Howard Stern Show.
Oh, here we go.
In Hills, Fort Lauderdale Beach, Florida. He is the five-time world's welterweight champion of the world, Dirty D.
Also hear Fred the Elephant Boy in the Howard Stern Show.
Partner,
keep that in mind.
He is incomparable. He is known as the Flamingo Kid. They call him Pinky. Here it is, ladies and gentlemen, Pinky, the Flamingo Kid.
Wait, was that Pinky or was that Stinky?
Pinky, that's Pinky.
Pinky or Funky?
Pinky. All right, now we got that straightened out.
What's Flex Wither doing picking on my good friend, Pinky?
Your good friend. You're friends with all the Pack, don't you? You're going to be partying in the Pack room tonight, aren't you?
We're tight.
You and the Pack are tight, huh? That's what I thought. Anyway, what a tag team match here. Cage Terror 2, Eastern Wrestling Federation. Man, what a night so far. I'm losing my voice, and we haven't even hit intermission yet.
If you'd shut your big mouth, you'd have your voice.
I wasn't working alone out here. All right, here we go. Pinky trips up. Flex Wheeler. Rough Riders. Know all four of these individuals, but it's been a while since I've seen them in action. All right. Flex Wheeler with a nice arm drag takeover. Now Pinky complaining of the hair pull. I didn't see any kind of hair, but I know. You did.
You're right.
Yeah, I know. Your monitor is way different than mine. You're right.
Brian Logan, he misses all the action. They need to mandate eye tests for the referees here.
He might be still trying to feel the shot he took earlier in that first match.
He deserved it.
Now you better check who pulled who hair. Check the hair there, ref. Pinky may be complaining that there's something on Flex Wheeler's head. Fans getting all over the pack. They also have their enemies too here, third degree.
Everyone should love and respect the pack. If they know what's good for them.
Yeah, if they don't respect them, they'll beat it out of you, that's for sure.
Look at what they almost did with that penguin, midget, troll.
Please stop it. You have no beef with him.
Willow.
You have no beef with that guy. Flex Wheeler. Now, bam, what a clothesline. Pack is in control so far. It's an obvious choke, ref. Can you please break it? Can you count faster? J-Love trying to get the crowd behind them. Dirty Deeds in the ring.
Five time.
Was it up to now? Five, are you sure?
That's how they announced it.
Alrighty.
Welterweight champion.
You're right. He made that belt famous. He put that belt on the map.
He's defended it in six continents. He's still waiting for the big debut show in Antarctica.
Whips him in now.
Reversal by Wheeler.
Oh, what an elbow. Oh, Darren Wise, and he's looking. That's, now, there's a Darren Wise I know. I don't think Pinky wanted to get back in that soon. I mean, come on. I mean, Darren Wise was in the ring for what, one moment? He had one elbow and he tags out? Come on. He's a pack member. They're supposed to be strong and tough and take it.
Pinky. He knows Pinky can handle the job.
Well, I hope so.
Darren has a big defense this weekend.
Oh, Jay Love won't be doing any romancing later on tonight. Nice.
Alabama Jam.
Pinky with a pin. I hope Darren Weiss has rested up now. I hope he's okay to go back in.
Oh, yeah.
Beautiful tag team work on part of Pinky and Darren Wise.
Like you said, they're like brothers.
They travel everywhere, folks. They show up to the arena together. They party together. Oh! What a clothesline by J-Love!
What do you take his head off?
I look at Darren Wise once out again. Oh, come on! What kind of tag was that? He tugged his knee! I'm sorry, but if I'm Pinky, I'm thinking, come on, carry your part of the team. I mean, okay, yeah, it's a tag team, but be fair about it.
That's why you have a partner.
Well, I mean,
when you're in trouble, you can make that tag.
This isn't even a tag team. Pinky's doing the whole thing in there.
He is not.
Well, at any rate,
carrying the show.
Pinky's back in it. I think Pinky needs a breather more than Darren Wise does.
Trying to build dissension.
No, no,
the pack.
It's heavy. I mean, I'm
that's
not.
What you're here for.
No, I'm not saying that there's dissension. What I'm saying is, I think Darren Wise should do his due share in the tag team.
You're out here rooting for Tiny. What are you, anti-pack?
Yeah, you're right. I don't like the pack. Okay.
About time you finally admit it.
Now, what is Darren Wise doing? Pay attention. You know, if anybody should have got kicked out of the Pack, I'm thinking Darren White. If I'm the Pack, I'd kick him out. What has he done in this tag team match that's been beneficial so far?
Look at this.
Finally, teamwork. I look right back out. Please.
What a wimp. Almost a minute.
What a wuss.
Here we go.
Now there. Now that is, even though it's illegal, that is great tag team work. Too bad the referee's been, you know, slammed around the first match. Maybe you catch that.
Darren Wise has never cheated in any relationship.
Oh. You just brought up the thing about his girlfriend and wife or whatever. What do you call that?
It's a dream, an agreement.
Oh, okay.
Working agreement.
A tag to Darren Wise. Let's see how long this lasts.
Working on the ankle.
Now, how long has Pinky been in there, do you think? Now, give him a breather. Don't you agree with that? You're a big Pack, Mark. Come on. Don't you agree
They have their game plan. They're sticking to their game plan.
I don't think Darren Wise is included in that game plan. Anyway, he's unloading on Jay Love right now. Whips him in. Reversal. Oh, good move by Darren Wise. He telegraphed that maneuver.
Could he be setting up for a powerbomb here?
Or a pile driver? I don't think so. No, he couldn't get him up. Maybe he'll try it again.
Jay Love tries to block it.
He said, whoa, no.
Oh.
Put him over. Oh, now what in the world?
Make the tag.
Come on. You gotta be killing. I'm begging Darren Wise to stay in the ring.
Darren Wise knows where he's at in the ring. Doesn't want to give the advantage to the Rough Riders. Makes the tag. Gets the freshman in there, Pinky.
Now Pinky's making sure he's okay. Oh, look out. Here we go. Double Logan Knocker. Oh, man. Here we go. It's breaking down now. The Rough Riders are getting rough with the Pack. Sets him in now. Pinky's in the ring. So's Jay Love. Here goes Darren Wise. What a beautiful maneuver. It's at one, two. Oh, there's Pinky. Good tag team right there. Pinky's right in there. Now Pinky trying to get, oh, wait a minute. What is this? Pinky's throwing Darren Wise back in the ring. I think maybe Pinky's getting a little upset with Darren Wise, and rightly so.
There's no need for this.
But no need for what? If Darren Wise would do his job, there wouldn't be a need for it. Now Jay Love taking over on Pinky, who has really absorbed a lot of punishment. Whips him in, comes off. Beautiful.
Sidewalk slam.
Beautiful. One, two, hook the leg. No, no, not on Pinky. Uh-uh.
Now Pinky has to know to make the tag to Darren Wise. Darren was so astute to know when to make the tag.
Beautiful tag team on the other side of the Rough Riders. Here, the double suplex. Great. And they have 5 seconds. Am I right? Am I right? A pin. No.
He's not going to get Pinky dead either. Pinky's held many belts. Pinned many a man.
You're right. Nice power slam by Flex for the pin. One, two. Darren Wise breaking that up, but uh-oh, Flex had enough of that. Look out. What is Darren doing? Please. He's holding on to our rope like he's married to it. Will that make it a threesome then, or a foursome? Or
was he holding both ropes?
Forget it. Pinky comes off. Beautiful maneuver. Takes the air out of Flex. Great move. Flex never saw it coming. Pinky now with his feet in the ropes, referee.
I can't see it from where I'm at.
I'll tell you, he has his feet in the ropes and the referee caught him.
That's a first.
I think maybe Pinky needs a breather, please. Now, this is, now watch Darren Wise, referee. Ah, come on. This is where I think there should be two referees.
This is where the Pack itself.
Two, this is how the Pack gets it done, right? All illegal. This is how they get it done.
It's J Love's fault. He's distracting the referee.
Yeah, you're right. J Love trying to tell the referee that there's a double team going on. Pinky now unloading on Flex Wheeler.
Fletch deserves it.
I like how they're keeping him close to the Pack's corner. That's important.
Reversal by Wheeler. Leg sweep.
Tags in. Sweet daddy. Looks like Pinky needs a breather. My God. Oh! Beautiful move for the pin one. Oh, the rep. Oh, come on. That was a blatant elbow to the referee. Ring the bell.
What he had to do to get the job
Ring
done.
The bell. What is going on?
With all the crap he calls. Oh,
good God.
Hello, ring pull. J-Love.
Here comes. Where's Darren Wise going?
What's he going for?
What is going on? Darren Wise. I don't know where he went or what he's getting.
I think he's got a chair, RC.
Oh, my God. He does have a chair, and the referee is still down. Don't let this happen. Flex Wheeler. Oh, no.
Perfectly legal.
If he lands this. Oh, my God. Oh, it backfired.
What's
it
Darren
backfired.
Doing?
Darren Wise hit his own team member. Oh, my God. If there was a distinction before, there is now.
What's Darren doing?
Oh, he pulled. He got pulled. There's the pin, too. And there it is.
Ladies and gentlemen.
What a set of circumstances.
4 seconds. Your winners.
The Rough Riders did win the match. Darren Wise lost the match for the Pack.
I agree. But what's going to happen? How's the Pack going to take to this now? We could see maybe other people leaving the Pack before this night's over.
Never.
Oh, okay. There's no distinction now in the group, you don't think. Look what Darren Wise did.
It was purely an accident. You're trying to make trouble.
No, I'm not. I'm just saying what's out there. Pinky had to wrestle that whole match, and Darren Wise did one thing, and he screwed it up.
Darren did more than 50%.
Darren Wise is worthless in this business.
You are trying to start trouble here in the EWF.
I'm just saying what happened. Darren Wise, now he's trying to apologize to Pinky.
It was purely an accident.
Side up. We're going straight to the top. We want tag title shot. Rough Riders style.
There you go, baby. Rough Riders in the house.
Great words of wisdom by Flex.
But now, more importantly, how is Darren Wise going to explain?
He's never met a microphone he didn't like.
How is he going to explain this to Pinky?
It was purely an accident.
I wish I had a microphone in the ring. Give them a... Uh-oh. Wait a minute. They're going to go right here.
There's no need for
Bring it on.
An accident.
Bring it on. Get the cage up. Bring it on. Yeah, there you go. The Pack isn't so tough now, are they?
There's no need for this.
What do you mean there's no need? If you were Pinky, what would you do? I know what the crowd wants to happen, and I agree with them. Oh, don't fall for it, Pinky. Don't fall for it.
Pack is thicker than blood.
Yeah, that was evident on August 7th. Come on. Pinky, don't fall for it.
Survival of the fittest. That's what would happen on August 7th. Yee-hoo! Pack,
of course.
Still together.
Of course.
Still strong.
Of course. What was I thinking? Why would you have your own individual thoughts? Well, I'm sorry, but if I got hit by a chair by my partner, it wouldn't be much of a decision for me. And I'm even questioning if it was an accident or not.
It was an accident.
I don't know about that.
You're a troublemaker.
I'm not a troublemaker.
I'm just saying what happened.
I don't know if it was an accident or not.
Purely an accident.
If I was Pinky, it wouldn't be much of a decision for me. I'd dump him. I know that for a minute.
Wait a minute. If you were Pinky, you'd weigh 300 pounds.
I don't want no trouble from you.
Hey, there's no problem right here. You understand that? My fault.
It's purely an accident. It didn't look like an accident to me.
Purely an accident, I told you, RC.
If I was Pinky, I'd question it. I know that right now.
Ladies, I know Pinky. To start trouble. I told you you were.
Once again, I'd like to
I wish he would have hit you with the chair.
November the 19th.
Well, that's nice.
Right here.
You deserved it.
At the Castle Hill Ballroom.
You're trying to start trouble with the Pack.
Will be here.
with EWF.
We better change seats. I don't want to sit in the end anymore.
Probably tonight only. There are t-shirts, one-of-a-kind t-shirts, on sale for $15 featuring the Cage of Terror 2. The t-shirts are on sale for $15 right now. And once again, I'd like to remind everyone that at Hampton Lanes, after tonight's EWF action,
coming
you
up
can
next.
Meet your EWF wrestling stars.
The big dance-off.
Right now, we're going to have something very special. I guess you saw in your announcements. This is going to be the special dance-off match.
Now, what are the rules for the dance-off?
I know both of these gentlemen personally, and it is quite a treat to see either
What's
one of them
talking
dance.
About?
To see them in a competition will be incredible.
I'm not going to comment on that.
Let's get ready for the next match. It is the special dance-off match.
What are the rules? Do you know?
Dance.
Don't you start dancing, please.
Love Bug and his manager Jimmy Agee. That's one big mirror.
My God. Now what are they doing?
Oh, baby, look at him dance.
Please, save it for the ring. They need security to help them with the mirror?
Look at Jimmy the Geek, Dan.
Jimmy the Geek, come on!
He's an incredible dancer also.
You put Jimmy the Geek and Bob Starr in the same room and you nerd, all the women are going to him, I know that.
Comes out to the Bee Gees is a superstar in my book.
Now, do they have to, is it going to be a wrestling match or are they going to just be dancing? Do you know anything that's going on here tonight? I feel like Pinky out here and by myself.
I know the Pack is ready to get even with you tonight.
What? Why with me? I'm a commentator. What the?
Troublemaker, you mean?
Once that cage gets put up, I'm nowhere near it. Finally, oh, come on. Jimmy the Geek.
Wearing his hot pants.
Yeah, he's... Man, he's on fire tonight, isn't he? Set that mirror up, baby. Oh, come on. Oh, oh. Here you go. That's what I like to see. Does Love Bug realize he is wrestling a legend in this sport? A legend.
He's facing off against Sal Buomo?
No. He is facing off with the man that started me in this business today. Jimmy Dio.
Who?
You know exactly who I'm
Never
talking
heard
about.
Of him. Oh, that guy who said, hey, the hey guy.
He started me off in wrestling. It'll be good to see him again.
Did he get a refund on that?
Here we come, baby, Jimmy Dio.
Why?
He's
why?
A legend! Look at him!
His own mind. Blandon's favorite son. Too bad there's only three people who live in Blandon. Jimmy, his mom, and his dad.
Look at him! They're doing the Jimmy dance already out here.
He better not quit his day job selling cars.
Wow. some moves by Jimmy Dio. Find out the rules for this match.
Ladies and gentlemen,
you just step aside and let Jimmy the Geek do all the talking here.
Please, yeah, thank you.
I have a little bit of explaining to do here, all right? Now listen to me here. Now we here at the Eastern Wrestling Federation notice here tonight that there's a lot of girls in the audience. So, now we're going to do something a little bit different here and have a dance contest. And we're going to see he's better, which I know already that you're going to think that the Love Bug is better.
Oh, please.
Or if Tito is the better dancer. Here we got two good-looking guys in the ring here. Two of the best in the EWF, but, you know, the Love Bug has no competition. This is the start of every woman's fantasy world tour, and it's going to start here.
Oh, God.
And let me tell you something. The Love Bug is my protege, and I'm very
please.
You ladies want to see them dance?
I think your girlfriend's on the road trip for that tour.
Because I'm not a very good judge.
I'm not commenting. I'm not going to get involved in your little games.
Here we go.
You know Love Bug's the better dancer.
All right. Who's the judge? Referee?
Love Bug starts it first. Look at this. Go ahead, man.
Oh, yeah, they're great.
Shake it, baby.
Oh, please. Chippendale, he is not.
He's got more moves than an 80-year-old drinking prune juice.
Oh, my God. What in the world? I think I see the females in the audience going to the bathroom. They're running towards the bathroom.
You know why, baby. Oh,
wait, stick
these
in, you know. You girls can do better than that. Now, he's not all that bad. Here, come on. You need to give us a little bit more respect here, all right? Just because you're so goddamn high and mighty.
Love Bug has served more people than McDonald's.
You're making me mad. All right?
How many more lines are we going to pull out?
You people start to wise up and start to smarten up that I won't curse in here anymore.
Well, that's good. I don't want him to get spanked by his mommy later on.
All right.
Geek.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Now's the Jimmy Dio's turn.
It's not the Love Bug's turn. I wish it was. But, okay.
Jimmy they wanted Dio to take off the town.
Please, God, no. We're going to mash potato.
Beautiful. Look at that. Yeah, baby. He's going to town. Yeah.
And he likes a reverse cowgirl.
Yeah. I might get up and do some dancing myself.
Please don't.
Jimmy Dio. I knew he was a great wrestler. Now he's also a great dancer. Look at him go to town, man.
I remember him from his Solid Gold days.
What? I don't know what that maneuver is. Nor do I want to find out.
All right, stop the music. Stop it right now. All right, now.
Come on.
And you say Jimmy Dio's a good dancer.
Yes.
All right.
Better than that.
How many fingers
that
do I have?
Walt
about?
Disney wait, guy.
How many fingers it? Do I have?
Come about? On.
Hit it, Love Bug, baby.
Not again.
Here's the dancer.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Oh, God.
Break out the mops, if you know what I mean.
Nothing to say.
For the kids that don't miss.
I have nothing to say. Oh, thank you.
Is money maker.
Thank you so much.
He's got more than coins in that bag, if you know what I mean.
You were on fire here.
Time to stop again. Now, hey. Thank you for those round of applause and seeing
better stuff. I'm getting excited
here tonight.
Who are you voting for?
Love Bomb.
Hey,
you know what? I think we already got a winner, but these guys got to go three times each.
Time for Jimmy Dio.
I hate to say it, but here we go again with Jimmy Dio. So, Jimmy Dio.
Great move, man. Yeah, I love it. Could have swore I saw him on the grind on MTV. Could have swore. Spring Breaks, I saw him. Look at that. Look how quick he is. What the? Uh-oh.
Thank God.
Don't give him too much, Jimmy.
Here comes the poster child for birth control.
Oh, God.
All right, shut that stupid music off.
I like that song.
Let me ask you something. You people look at yourselves a lot in the mirror. You guys look awful ridiculous. So.
Has he looked at, what is Jimmy to get, why,
you know. He's a fine dresser.
Give me a chair, I want to lay him out.
All right, hit the Love Bugs music one more time.
Woohoo! Oh, no!
Yeah,
man. Oh, no, no, I'm not going to watch. I'm not going to watch.
You're doing more than watching.
Oh, oh, good God, no, yeah, thank you. Oh, come on.
I think there's about 10 women in line ready to leave their husbands.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, stop the music. Now, as you know,
they want to ride on the Love Bug.
Might be thinking, well, you know, come on, we got to get on. So, all right, so that's exactly what we're going to do. Low, okay. So now it's Jimmy Dio's turn. Hit the music once again.
This was a dance-off!
I say the Love Bug wins.
Look at that. Well, look at Jimmy the geek, the dud, the loser in there. Look at Love Bug now, the sore loser. Jimmy Dio with those great-looking boxers. Come on!
The rules of the dance-off clearly stated no metallic rights.
DDT by Jimmy Dio. He has about one, two, and he got him! He got him! That's it! It's over! Jimmy Dio, the legend! Oh, what? Oh. Yeah, beautiful, baby!
He has no right to touch the G.
Beautiful! Oh, 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 wait a minute!
Chad Austin doing?
What in the hell? Oh, no! Jimmy Dio caught him! Look out, look out! Oh! And the Love Bug have gotten kind of a close relationship here.
Is Chad Austin foaming from the mouth?
I don't want to look. I don't want to look.
Look at the Love Bug there.
Oh, great.
Unity. That's what it's all about.
After that, they have all their choice. They might as well move in with each other.
What are you saying? Glad my wife isn't here.
Wrestling fans, we have much more to come. We have the two big main events, barbed wire, steel cage. cage match coming up for the EWF Light Heavyweight Championship. Mongoose, George Anthony, the current champion, these two have been gone back and forth many a time.
Great. And then we have the big 4-on-4 barbed wire cage tear too.
Michael, Hungarian Barbarian, Adam Flash, Wildman Sal Balomo, and the Samoan gangster LA Smooth.
Against my boys.
Yeah, the pack. I know.
Cronus, the Doomer, Doomsday Danny Rose, and the Bad Crew.
How's that shoulder? I want to know. You find out during intermission.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will be taking a short intermission at this time to set up for the rest of the evening's matches. Don't forget, Cage of Terror. All right, ladies and gentlemen. This next match of the evening, ladies and gentlemen, is for the EWF Light Heavyweight Championship. It has a 1 hour time limit with one fall.
We are back here, wrestling fans, EWF, and I can't believe this. We are joined at the conference. Were you behind this?
I might be.
Third degree, we have, I can't, Darren Wise, what are you doing out here?
Well, now, you know, I'm always, you know, my biggest concern is always your ratings and, you know, your video sales and all that type of thing. So I figured I'd come out here and cut you guys a break. Bring, you know, one of the most high-profile wrestlers in the whole entire business. Yours truly, Dirty Deeds, Darren Wise, come down here and sit beside you, big man.
Well, are you going to talk about what happened earlier tonight?
I want to talk about Howard Stern.
Howard Stern or what happened earlier tonight? You know, I can go off all night long on whatever you want to talk about. So just, you know, hang on and we'll get to it.
All right, I want to know what's going on with you and Pinky. That's what I want to know.
Okay, so anyway, I go to the Howard Stern show.
Oh, yeah, that's what I thought. Here comes Mongoose, baby. This is for the EWF Light Heavyweight Championship. Mongoose, George Anthony, the current champion. A guy you know pretty good.
Who's that?
George Anthony.
I'm sorry, I wasn't paying attention.
Anyway, this has gone back and forth. How many times now we're going to settle inside a cage with barbed wire wrapped around it?
Why don't you say what you were saying about him before?
I was saying how I don't think you held up your part of the tag team match.
Well, let's talk about this big barbed wire cage match. We'll get back to that tag team thing. You know, 1 year ago, pretty much 1 year ago to the date, old Dirty Deeds was in there doing the same thing, you know, and I'm kind of itching to get myself back in there. I love this type of match. I love that style. I love the barbed wire, the thumbtacks, and all that type of thing.
You're doing more dancing than Jimmy Deal was out here before, dancing around here. My God.
He's probably a better dancer, though.
Mongoose is ready. Here comes the current EWF Light Heavyweight Champion, member of the Pack,
George Anthony.
I know you want to say it. You're a big pack, Mark. Here we go, baby. Here he is. Any advice?
There we go, baby. George Anthony, you got to love him. And I guarantee you, I don't need to give that man advice because he's taking it to the top tonight. Mongoose is out of his league.
Here we go. We started off. Ring the bell. Thank you so much. This is for the Light Heavyweight Championship. And George Anthony, no nonsense, is going to him, baby.
Mongoose, Chipmunk, whatever his name is, he has no chance.
All right. Just because you're a big fan of the Pack. Beautiful, beautiful. Oh, what a move by Mongoose. Big clothesline.
Yeah, well, I'm not liking what I'm seeing so far here.
You just stay here and don't worry about it. Well, Mongoose with a great drop kick. George Anthony almost into the side of the cage. You don't want to go there, that's for sure. Folks, there's barbed wire all through that cage. I mean, a cage match is brutal enough, but put barbed wire in it, my God. Mongoose in a pin, 1-2. No way, not on George Anthony. You kidding me?
Look at that Pee-wee-O moving around in there. He's like a little monkey.
Legendary Pee-wee in the ring. Mongoose in the turnbuckle. Lighten them up. Both wrestlers have their fighting gear on. Look how, man, what authority in there. Nice clothesline under the turnbuckle.
Mongoose wishes, he wishes he was in the Pack.
I know, everyone wishes to be in the Pack.
Everybody wants to be in the Pack because that's the elite group. That's the place to be, Daddy-O.
I don't, all right, for the record.
Well, I can comment on that, but I don't think we want to go there.
You guys kick Tiny out. I don't understand that at all.
Survival of the fittest. Get rid of the weak link.
Weak link. Don't go back to that.
That's right, Daddy-O. When you're talking about the Pack, you're talking about the world's welterweight title. You're talking about the EWF tag team titles. You're talking about the EWF NCW heavyweight title. You're talking about the EWF light heavyweight title. Tiny, really, you know, he was used up. He had nothing left to offer.
All right. What a side slam by George Anthony.
And he surely wasn't pulling his weight when it came to picking up the trim.
Told you.
Kick out by Mongoose. Man, I'm good. What a treat this is. I'm like a thorn between two roses here. George Anthony taking care of Mongoose. Man, these two back and forth, how many months now? We're finally going to settle it inside the cage.
Well, you know, if you want to go back in EWF history, there was a long, long running feud between George Anthony and Jay Love as well. And you know how that ended up. Jay Love being on the wrong side of that one. He's out here tagging up with some other chicken-eating, greasy welfare check collecting. Well, you saw him. You saw me and Pinky destroy him earlier on tonight.
I think I saw Pinky destroy him, but that's a different story. George Anthony, your man just went into the cage, and that has to nothing but trouble for the Pack.
Well, you know, that's part of being in the cage, and you're gonna expect that, and it's gonna happen, and you know it, and you prepare yourself for that.
I really can't tell from my vantage point if how badly hurt George Anthony is, but Mongoose in control. Uh-oh.
Wait, he's threatening to kick him in his ball bag, and I don't like that.
Please. Well, you surely didn't like that then. Mongoose for the pin. One, two. No, it kicks out.
I'm getting itchy.
What do you mean you're getting?
I'm too far from the action is what I'm trying to tell you.
Well, you just stay right here and don't worry about the action. This is a fine match without you. You just stay right here.
Well, I am. All right, I'm staying because you guys need me, and that's the only reason.
Well, no.
You're trying to cause trouble again.
What? No, why? You're
my
trying to...
My friend Darren Wise comes out here to carry you.
You're trying to get me in trouble. I'm just stating the fact.
His arms aren't that big to carry you.
Anyway, oh, there goes Mongoose. Oh, my goodness. Woo! Cheers from Darren Wise.
You got to love that. You got to love that, baby. Here comes Georgie.
Can you please call it down the line, all right? If you're going to commentate.
I'll call her straight down the middle, Daddy-O.
Thank you.
George Anthony, one of the greatest wrestlers ever. Mongoose, he's not in the same league. He doesn't even belong in a cage with the man.
Well, I don't know about that.
And he's proving it right now.
And what a kick out by Mongoose, might I add.
Yeah, George is toying with him. He's not quite ready to be, you know, wrap him up and throw him out quite yet.
So how was it like? What was the meeting like with the Pack, with you and Pinky and the distension? How'd that meeting go?
What was that word you just used?
Distension.
Distension? Do you want to define that for me? Do I have to pull out the Webster's Dictionary? Dissension.
Just like there's problems now with George Anthony into the cage. Man, oh man, this is not the night for the Pack. I'm calling it right now.
Well, till it's all said and done, RC, it will be Piggly Wiggly night for the Pack. With all the belts coming back home, everything, you know how it is.
Mongoose getting fired up now. Blocks it, what a shot by Mongoose. He could taste it. He wants that light heavyweight belt, and he's going to put George Anthony through the cage. Where are you going?
I'm just getting, I can't, I you, can't.
You stay right here, Darren Wise. Oh, no, you don't go anywhere. Mongoose, what an elbow. You know what's happening. Look at, wait a minute. Where are you going?
I'm not going anywhere. I'm right here in my seat. I'm in my seat.
You stay right here. I'll tell Pee-wee to watch you.
Well,
the best thing Mongoose is doing is bleeding all over the place.
Third degree, you got to control him.
Hey, I don't want Pee-wee watching me any more than he already does. About 2 nights ago, 3 o'clock in the morning, I open up the blinds. There's a little boy, little man, sticking his head. He's going on the outside, looking in, doing one of these.
All right, okay, we don't have to get into that. No, you just stay here. You're doing a fine job right here.
The feel of the barbed wire and then the metal and
Well, then why aren't you in the match then? What are you doing? Darren Wise is getting up. Sit down. What are you doing? Just stay here.
I got answers. I got the proverbial answer in my pants.
No, you just stay right here. I don't care about your hemorrhoidal problem. You stay here. DDT by Mongoose. Third degree, you invited this guy. Where are you going? Get back here. You forgot your sunglasses. Sit down. Sit down, Darren Wise. Mongoose is busted wide open.
Let him alone.
What do you mean let him alone? I can't trust this
guy.
All right,
I'm back.
Just stay right
That's
here.
It. I can't stay.
What are you? You just go back. Get back here.
All right.
Sit down.
Okay, I'm back. But
good. All right. Anyway, Mongoose trying
to... My nerves.
I know. Well, just calm down. Everything...
I got to go.
Where are you going now? Where you... No. They're going... Will you... You invited this... Just sit down. You invited this guy over here. Sit down. You invited... Go control
You're
him.
You're a troublemaker.
What did I didn't do anything? Mongoose...
You're making him leave. You don't want him here.
Someone tell Pee-wee that dirty Jesus. Get him out of there. We don't... He doesn't belong down there.
Leave him alone.
But leave him alone. Look at this. George Anthony's busted open. Mongoose is busted open. That steel cage with the barbed wire having its effect already. George Anthony saying he's going up. This could be all it. This could be over.
This could be it.
I can't believe there. Oh no! Oh no! Mongoose got him.
He
got him. Oh! He took him down. Mongoose is a bloody mess. They're both bleeding profusely.
He's a bloody cheater is what he is.
But how can you say that?
He grabbed the tights.
Come on! Open the door. Mongoose can just come out of the. Oh! Come on! See?
That's why Dirty Deeds is here.
I knew it. Referee, what now? What the hell is this? Oh, come on!
They're gonna put you through one of those tables.
No, this now, we should stop this. This is uncalled for. The crowd's going nuts, and so am I. You knew this was gonna happen.
They're gonna hurt Mongoose.
Where were you during intermission? You were involved in the meeting with the pack.
I might have been.
Not one, but two tables. You gotta be kidding me. Now Darren White shuts the door. What a great guy. And there's this, the referee is allowing this to happen.
Playing by the book, Darren White.
What in the... Mongoose is hurt. The referee should stop the match. And what are you doing? What the hell are you doing?
He's not hurt yet. What? Darren's just helping out.
Who's wrestling in this match? Oh, no. He's stacking the tables. What is George Anthony doing?
The deck is definitely stacked against Mongoose here.
Oh, I don't want to be Mongoose. Ring the bell. Don't allow this to happen. The referee has to do something about this. Oh, my God.
We'll see Mongoose in a hospital bed tonight.
Oh, my, no. No, no. Stop the match. Stop the match!
What? Get out the beneficiary check.
I said someone's
gonna
get hurt.
The life insurance policy.
Someone's gonna get hurt. And
it's gonna be Mongoose.
He's going all the way up, not just to the top turnbuckle. What's he gonna do?
It's all about the pack.
No, he's gonna go up to the top of the cage. He's gonna go from the top. Jesus, my voice will not hold up.
This is why he's one of the best high flyers. George
my Anthony. Voice will not hold up. Oh, my God.
Oh, baby.
Oh, my God.
Mongoose ain't kicking out of that one.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Did you see that, RC? Big splash through two tables.
He's dead. He's hurt. Ring the bell. Jeeper.
Find him a body bag.
That's incredible.
It's all about the pack, baby.
What the hell? You mean? Wait a minute.
Wait a minute. What happened?
Wait a minute.
Ladies and gentlemen,
wait.
We have a new.
Yes. 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 Now look at this. Oh, wait a minute. Mongoose is the new light heavyweight champion, and Pinky's pissed off.
Darren carried out the plan of the pack.
What is going on?
It's Pinky's fault.
Pinky's fault? What the hell are you talking about?
He was supposed to get in there, make sure George Anthony had the pin. He's too busy in the back, dilly-dallying.
I can't believe that. What happened? Uh-oh, wait a minute.
Yeah.
Wait a minute.
This is what we want.
Oh, no. He's not going to.
Get rid of the weak link.
Oh,
yeah,
Jesus.
There you go.
Oh, wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
Here comes Tiny. Here comes Tiny.
Darren head for higher ground.
Oh, my God. Tiny's in the ring. I can't believe these circumstances right now.
He who fights and runs away is able to live another day.
I can't believe this. I don't know if I could finish the night with my voice. What unbelievable.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, your new
Darren Wise. What the hell are you doing?
Darren's doing what the pack wants.
What are you doing?
Yeah, high five in your face.
Disgusting.
We don't need Peachy. We don't need Tiny.
What's this we?
The pack.
Oh.
They love me.
The bottom line is we have a new light heavyweight champion, and it's not George Anthony.
Mongoose got lucky.
Incredible match.
If Pinky would have did his job, carried out the plan of the pack, George Anthony would still be the light heavyweight champion.
You are ridiculous.
The new lightweight champion.
One but two tables. Do you realize that?
What's going on here in the ring?
Where's George Anthony and Tiny and Pinky? And Mongoose is still in the ring.
Has he moved yet?
Oh, yeah.
Not much.
Well, what's going to happen here? What a situation this is. There you go. George Anthony raising the hand of Mongoose.
Mongoose, ladies and gentlemen.
That was incredible.
Oh, now Pinky's not really happy with that.
What's going on?
I don't know what the hell's going on. You and your pack, I don't think they know what's going on.
You're trying to start trouble, aren't you?
What do you mean I'm trying to start trouble? I can't even talk.
Short hand swallow.
You know, you are one disgusting person. Now, Pinky,
call
George Anthony, and Tiny are leaving together.
Federation champion, here is Mongoose.
They're leaving together. Pinky's not happy. I don't know what's going on.
I don't understand.
I don't know either. I'm confused. One thing I do know, though, coming up next, nothing but pure violence.
There he is, your new EWF light heavyweight champion, Mongoose.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we get the next event going, I'd like to remind you there is extremely, a very, very limited amount of Cage of Terror 2 t-shirts available tonight, and tonight only. There are very few left. I heard five was the last count. They're $15. If you'd like to get your last t-shirt, get it now. It'll be gone forever. This will be the main event.
We talked about it all night.
Here are the rules.
Read them to me, brother.
One member from each team will start the match. Those two will battle for 5 minutes before another wrestler enters. Then a coin toss will determine what team gets the advantage.
The team gaining the advantage will then send their next man into the cage. Every 2 minutes thereafter, the teams will alternate sending wrestlers into the cage. Once all members from both teams are in the cage.
They're all dirty deeds of seats. Shut the hell up. I don't care what you're talking about.
Are you
reading the damn sponsors again?
No, we're talking about the cage terror rules.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
What are you doing back? What in the hell's going on with the pack?
My work there is done. Now I'm back here with you.
What? George Anthony's no longer the light heavyweight champion.
Easy come, easy go, what can I say?
Now, what was that what you did to Pinky?
He has been really getting on my nerves tonight.
I agree with you.
He deserves it. I think it's his time of the month or something.
Page of Terror 2.
Here we go.
Once again, there are
limited t-shirts available. Get them while you can. Right now, I'll read the rules to the Cage of Terror.
I hope you're staying here for this match.
From each team.
You know, I got a little antsy in that last one, didn't I?
Yeah.
Those two
I'll have to admit that.
5 minutes before another wrestler enters the ring. A coin toss will determine which team member goes to get the advantage. The team member gaining that advantage will send their next man into the cage. Every 2 minutes thereafter, the teams will alternate sending wrestlers to the cage. Once all members from both teams are in the cage of terror will begin. A definite winner will be crowned by pinfall or submission.
All righty, here we go.
Let's get the wrestling action going, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Cage of Terror 2.
Ah, there's that familiar sound we all love, the pack music.
Now, who are your friends with here?
All the packs in full force.
Oh, obviously. Obviously. Now you just stay right here. All the meeting, all the hype is over. You stay right here.
I'll try.
Yeah. Here they come, baby. I'll tell you what, I don't like the pack, but it's one awesome team right there.
You got it, baby. And you know what's on the other side? Sal Spaghetti-O, Adam Crash, a batch of Samoans.
Please, you're as much help as he is.
Hungarian Barbarian, whoa. What did he do, win an MTV contest?
All right, here we go. Here come the opponents.
He'll sell you some good used furniture, though.
All right. We don't need that. Here we go now. Maybe you want to flip the coin eventually.
You know what? Now, this time we're going to talk just about this match. No Dirty Deeds and Howard Stern, and how much Howard Stern loves Dirty Deeds, and how much Robin Quivers love Dirty Deeds, and how much Jackie and Fred, and how much they love Dirty Deeds. None of that. None of that, okay?
What about Casey loving Dirty Deeds?
Who's that?
Casey.
I think that Casey boy, he's a little, I don't know. He's from the other side of the tracks or something.
Let's talk about Pinky.
I think he hits from the other side of the plate, if you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I know. Let's talk about Pinky.
We don't want to talk about how much Pinky respects my wrestling ability and how much,
God.
You know, he loves and understands everything that I do for him is for the best. And we're not going to talk about that. We're going to talk about Bad Crew, the Hungarian Barbarian.
Here we go.
Sal Spaghetti-O. That's it. Take it away, RC.
Here we go, baby. Cage Terror 2 is going to begin. One half of Bad Crew, Hungarian Barbarian. What a way to kick it off.
Hungarian Barbarian, you know, we got everything scouted here, don't get me wrong, but it's common knowledge, the Hungarian Barbarian with a broken wrist in there, and that's going to turn out to be a handicap somewhere through this match. You know, he did that fooling around on MTV somewhere, trying to be like Dirty Deeds.
Now, they'll go for 5 minutes, and then we'll flip the coin to see what team gets the advantage.
What's your prediction?
My prediction?
It's going to be wrong.
Well, then why even give it?
I don't know, you're taking up precious airtime.
please.
Well, we already got your prediction for tonight, right? You said it's Piggly Wiggly night for Bad Crew and the whole entire pack. I remember you saying that earlier on.
Never said that.
Was that me that said that?
Yes.
No, that was you.
What a shock. One of the Bad Crew taking control of the Hungarian Barbarian. Now I'm sure you guys, your team, the pack, knows about the, you know, the hurt wrist, the broken wrist on the Hungarian Barbarian.
Didn't I just say that, fat man?
Idiot? Are you an idiot?
No, I guess I'm the idiot here.
Come here. I'm going to slap you right upside your head.
Please, don't touch me. I have more lawyers on you than... Hungarian Barbarian, taking control.
You know, Cronus, you have to admit, Cronus is just a huge and very nice addition to, the pack. He's not an official pack member, but he's kind of the designated hitter.
Maybe after tonight, though.
Well, you never know now, do you?
What an awesome move by Hungarian Barbarian, taking him almost out of his boots.
See, now that's a damn blatant chokehold. Now we're in a match here where that, yeah, you should be having that type of thing.
Come on, anything goes, Dirty Deeds, and you know that.
That's only when the pack is dishing it out.
Oh, selective. I see.
You don't understand,
yeah,
do you?
I don't
understand. I told you all night.
Yeah, I know.
Hey, my God, Arson, I'm going to get back to this just one time. Can you just get the feel of the way the crowd came up when old Dirty Deeds, had to teach little Pinky there a lesson just a little while ago. That crowd came, I brought the place down.
And I think the Hungarian Barbarian is going to take one half of the Bad Crew down any moment.
Are you, A, trying to ignore my comment, and what? B, trying to segue off my comment into some kind of baloney of your own?
What do you mean? Look, you're seeing it right here. Hungarian Barbarian is having his way right now with one pack member. Big leg drop.
Well, I'm not sure, but having his way and pack and some other words are all things that are synonymous with the Hungarian Barbarian from what I hear in the locker room.
Please, we don't need that here. Now, how much time is left? Who's in charge of the time?
Well, let's check Big Ben. Big Ben, his batteries apparently have been pulled.
I know you're not controlling the coin toss. I know that. Nor are you, Third Degree.
You're right, but I'm going to guess.
What are you guessing?
That Sal Balomo sells used furniture.
Oh, please. Big DDT by Hungarian Barbarian. Sal Balomo all over the crowd.
My personal opinion is if this other team is smart, they'll save Sal Spaghetti-O for the anchor spot. You know, last guy in there, you know. But we'll see, because Sal will probably be next one in. This guy's probably right, you know, and that just shows the ignorance and then the thinking it through on the other side of the team.
Here we go.
Three.
Countdown's on.
Two. One.
Now we flip the coin. What? What's it going to be? Uh-oh. It looks like the pack won.
Here we go. I told you it'd be the
pack. Now it's 2-on-1. This is not going to be good for Hungarian Barbarian. Now it's going to be like this for 2 minutes, at least 2 minutes. And the match can't end. It can't end.
It's going to be real good for Hungarian Barbarian, right, Darren?
You got it, brother.
Hungarian Barbarian has to at least go for 2 minutes, man. But
this night's all about the pack, and you're going to find out why, RC.
Well, so far, one pack member has left light the gold. So far, it's not been a very good night for the pack.
Well, see, apparently you're not following along. He is no longer a pack member.
Oh, okay.
Good God.
Plan.
Good God, right, man.
All right.
RC, honestly, how long have you known Dirty Deeds? Am I
too long,
or am I not some sort of a wrestling wizard and managerial genius?
Oh, come on. Now, what the hell, Doomsday Daddy Rose? That is, come on. That should stop right there. He's not even the match, damn it. Don't let him do that.
You know, RC, you're absolutely right. That should stop till I can get down there and help him out. I think I'm going to go.
No. You stay right here. We've seen enough of you.
It's all about the ratings to you, isn't it, man?
Just stay here.
I'm here.
Hungarian Barbarian needs, oh, man. He's wishing for the 2 minutes to be up. Double clothesline. Bad Crew taking control.
Five.
Uh-oh.
Four.
Now, here we go.
Three.
Who will be next?
Two.
Who will be next?
One.
Here we go.
I think it's Adam Trash.
Oh, you're right. Here comes Adam Flash. Oh, boy.
Adam Trash.
Now, the sides are even for 2 minutes. Beautiful into the cage. Adam Flash taking control.
Somebody put out this house of fire already.
Oh, beautiful.
Good God, RC, you're wound up. I bet you got wood.
Adam Flash unloading on Bad Crew. Here we go. Cage Terror 2, you're witnessing it. Halloween's come early in the EWF. This is going to get ugly before it's all over. And the match can end. Into the cage. Oh, my God. The cage is wrapped with barbed wire. Please.
Look at that, RC. I think Cronus is lining up. He's going to be the next guy in, I think, for the pack.
If I was a referee, I would disqualify Cronus and make him leave.
For what reason?
Pushing him around.
I hope Cronus kills Brian Logan.
Oh, come on.
He's done nothing but interfere in the pack's business all night.
Oh, okay.
Brian Logan is one of the most incompetent referees you're ever going to find in the world of professional wrestling, hands down. So I got to agree with my man over here, the third degree.
Adam Flat, look, again, Bad Crew. Oh, my, into the cage with the barbed wire. Dirty Deeds, I can't believe you're sitting here.
Well, it's hard. It's one of the hardest things I had to do all night long. You know, and honest to God, I'd love to be in there, and everybody knows it.
Uh-oh.
Four,
who's going to be on?
Three,
who's going from the pack? You know it. Who is it?
I think it's going to be Cronus.
Here comes Cronus. This man isn't wrapped too tight. He's nuts. This is his kind of match.
Darren didn't have to carry Pinky all night long. He'd be in there right now.
Oh, don't start that.
You know, the man makes a good point.
Yeah, what a shock.
His back is sore from all the carrying he's done.
Could he use another member of the pack, you know, get this guy out of here?
You know, Cronus, the man's something else.
He's nuts. He's absolutely nuts. He should be put away. Whips him in the turnbuckle. Hungarian Barbarian is cut wide open. No surprise in this type of match, my God. Well, now, once again, the pack has taken over. Thanks to Cronus.
Well, that's his job, RC. He's 3-on-2 at this point in time. That's the rules of the match. You can't criticize the man. What's he supposed to come in there and sit and wait till, one of them damn Samoans comes in?
They could be next.
How many Samoans are here tonight? They're like a damn dime a dozen.
Watch out behind you.
Good Lord.
Bad Crew into the cage. Adam Flash. Unloading on Cronus now. Puts him. Oh, my God. The cage almost came down.
You know, right now, I'd give everything in my wallet to see Adam Trash busted wide open like a pig.
Why don't you go and do it? You've been involved in every cage match so far.
You want me to go? I'll go.
Huh? Gee.
I think you might eat.
Five.
Uh-oh.
Four.
Here we go.
Three.
You might have your wish. It could be one of the Samoans, like the Samoan gangster, L.A. Smooth, coming in right now, baby. Beautiful. Beautiful chop to the head. And another one. Unloading. Look at him go to town. Big headbutt. Oh, my God. Oh, what a shot. Good God. Another headbutt. Down goes Cronus.
I'm begging him to put some shoes on.
Cronus into the cage.
Unbelievable, RC. The action is almost at a point where it's hard to call, isn't it?
Oh, it's getting crazy in there now. I don't even know where to look. My monitor's all Adam Flash.
Adam Trash into the cage.
Good God. I think John Cronus is busted wide open, courtesy of that vicious shot into the cage. Hungarian Barbarian going to work on Cronus. Over in the corner, we have one half of Bad Crew with Adam Flash. Samoan Gangster taking care of the other Bad Crew member. Chaos, absolute chaos in the Eastern Wrestling Federation. Man, these guys are nuts in there. This is what you get every time from the EWF.
You know, I made a point earlier on, and these guys, they were smart. At least in my opinion, you keep Sal Spaghetti-O for your anchor man, for the last guy in, and that's exactly what they've done. On the other hand, the Pack going with Doomsday Danny Rose. He's going to be the last of the four in for the Pack.
Let me ask you about Doomsday's shoulder. How's that?
Doomsday's shoulder is in a hell of a lot better condition than the Hungarian Barbarian's wrist, and that's all I'm going to say about
that. Just wondering. Third Degree, are you still with us, my friend?
I can't get a word in edgewise between you two.
Well, look at this action. I mean, my God. Cronus is a mess in there.
There is blood everywhere. That's what you get with Cage Terror 2.
Five, four,
here we go.
Three, two, one.
Here comes Doomsday Danny Rose, baby. Oh, my God. Unloading on Adam Flash.
There he is, baby, the EWF NCW Heavyweight Champion of the world. And he's beaten everybody that's come down the line, and he's been in these kind of matches too. This is one game, mean, terroristic competitor in there, and you're going to see it right now.
What a boop on a Hungarian Barbarian. Now he gets whipped in, and he gets a big clothesline.
Doomsday cleaning house, Pack style.
I don't understand Doomsday, his hairstyle.
Somebody better call the blood bank, because the Hungarian Barbarian is donating, and they better get some vials over here to, like, scrape it all up.
Incredible. The match can't be stopped because of blood. Oh, man. I think now the Samoan Gangster's been busted open, too. There goes Danny Rose into the cage.
He might be bloody. I see it trickle through his blonde hair, and I don't like that. I don't like that.
Who isn't bleeding in this match so far?
Sal Bellomo.
Oh, please. We don't even need you in this. Oh, Danny Rose is cut wide open. My God. Oh, my. It looks like a car wreck out here.
Now, I don't know, you know, if the viewers know, there cannot be a finish to this match.
No.
Until now, at this point, Sal Spaghetti-O gets his ass in there. Every competitor must be in there until there can be any sort of pinfall submission type situation. So these guys, some of these guys have been in there now 12,
five,
15 minutes, the Hungarian
four,
Barbarian and the Bad Group.
Here we go.
Two,
Sal Bellomo now. Now, the match could officially start, and there goes the referee. Unbelievable. Cage Terror 2, baby. Here we are, full force.
Brian Logan, definitely, he's afraid to get in there. If he knows what's good for him, he's hesitating. He's finally in there.
I hope they bust his head wide open.
Oh, come on, please. We don't need that. He's doing his job. Incredible. Look at Cronus. He's a mess.
As always.
Everybody in that cage right now, RC, is a mess. It's between being cut up, bloody. You got to think the fatigue factor is really going to start to take effect now as well.
Unbelievable. What a mess.
What a match, you mean.
Oh, my God, did you hear that shot?
Bellomo, that's all I can say.
This is starting to have the looks of a big car crash out here, right out here on, Route 222.
I hope they have Bethlehem's Finest here in the ambulance, because somebody's going to ride in it. I can't believe I thought Mongoose would be going that trip, but he walked out with the light heavyweight championship. But someone's going to get hurt here. Mike, how much more could these people take in the ring? I can't tell. Is Sal Bellomo busted open?
I think he's just extremely ugly.
Sal Bellomo, a 75-year ring veteran in there.
Will you stop taking cheap shots at Sal Bellomo? Well-respected person in the business.
You know, I will admit it, I do have a lot of respect for Sal Spaghetti-O, because he has been around for a long time, you know, and he's what this business is all about. And for this team to make a run right now, for them to have a chance against the Pack, it's got to be Sal Spaghetti-O in there being the one leading the charge, because he's the freshest man in that cage right now.
Please, can you say his name right? I mean, come on.
Okay, Sal Spaghetti-O.
Anyway,
I don't know how, we can't even call this. I mean, it's chaos in the ring, folks. Eastern Wrestling Federation, man, they are bringing you the best in professional wrestling.
You're absolutely right, RC. Somebody better call Maxwell Smart, because chaos is all over the place here tonight.
Oh, look at Hungary. Oh, it's Cronus. I'm sorry. Oh, God, I couldn't even tell who he was. All the blood on his face. Oh, jeez. He's just kicking everybody, my God. Danny Rose is a mess in there. Look out, referee. Why would the referee even be in the ring? Why?
Look at Brian Logan. He's running like a scared little schoolgirl.
Oh, we have a first pinfall attempt. 1-2. No way. No way.
I'm sorry. I think Brian Logan is a scared little schoolgirl.
Stop it. Can you please be serious for one moment?
I am very serious, brother. Those are my brothers in there right now. I am dead serious.
How do you feel sitting back this far knowing all the destruction being had in the ring?
Well, you know, as bad as it is in there, I'm getting those ants in my pants.
No.
Yes, I am.
I will physically hold you here this time.
You won't. I'll hit you with a chair.
Oh.
Don't interfere in pack business.
Call my punk card out?
Yeah, punk.
Anyway. Look at this. Oh!
Total elimination!
Cronus! 1, 2, There it is!
Big pack victory! We told you, RC!
Ladies and gentlemen!
Cronus!
Party time, baby! Party time!
Big time!
The team of the Bad Crew!
Uh-oh, wait a minute! Hey, wait a minute!
Eliminator Cronus!
Hey, look who's out here!
Hi, guys! How are you?
Oh, yeah! Big mouth! It's Pinky, Tiny, and George Anthony out here looking on.
I don't know what they're doing.
I know what they're doing.
Their matches is over. They have no right to be out here.
I think they want to know. They want some explaining.
Who won the match? The pack. It's all about the pack. Who cares about Pinky, Tiny, and George Anthony?
But wait. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, my God. I think Pinky and Tiny and George Anthony are just saying goodbye via their fingers.
I think you're right. L.A. Smooth, a bloody mess. Hungarian Barbarian, a bloody mess. There is more blood in this than an average car accident.
Oh, it's incredible. Oh, wait a minute.
What's he doing with the chair?
Anything he wants.
I don't think this is over by a long shot.
It'd be a dumb move. What a night of wrestling. Eastern Wrestling Federation, incredible.
Everybody wants a piece of the pack, but jump back, Jack, because you're not going to get a piece of the pack.
Wrestling fans, what a night of wrestling you have in your VCR. My name is RC. You're the third degree.
That's right, brother.
It's been a pleasure. What a night. What a night of wrestling. Cage Terror 2. Incredible. Halloween has come early in the EWF.
You can see the Bushwhackers on November 12th, the Friday preceding. EWF will be at the Garfield on Main Street in Northampton.
What happened? What is it?
Oh my God.
LA Smooth.
just happened over here, though, Darren. Dirty Deeds. Pack member attacked. Are we still on here, third degree?
We're still on.
What? LA Gangster attacking
one half of Batroo.
Something going on here. Oh, wait a minute. I think
they're going to get him.
Oh, we need some security back there. I see some police officers here, please.
Like you said, EWF, the best.
Oh, I
in professional wrestling.
Incredible. I wasn't expecting that. It has been a great night of wrestling. What a way to end it. I'm speechless. I gotta go see what's going on here. I hear all kind of commotion in the back. There's something going on. I'm gonna go. I'm out of here, 30.
I'm with you.
I'm out of here.
See ya.
Jesus.
We thought we were done.
What the? We're still on.
Hungarian Barbarians choking out Tuesday Day
Room. This is crazy.
This is broken out all over.
We've got out of
control. Oh, my God, brother.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Danny Rose headed for higher ground.
Jesus Christ.
In the ring, L.A. Smooth, John Cronus.
Oh, this is.
This is
God.
Crazy.
That L.A. Smooth is the guy that attacked Bad Crew.
What's he going for? Oh!
Just broke him in half. He broke him in half. We've been trying to leave three times. Oh, wait.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
No, we need somebody to start. Now, this is getting out of hand. Oh, my God. That looked bad. That looked hard. Hungarian.
I wouldn't want to be John Cronus.
Oh, no. No, we do need some security to get in there.
This has to end.
I'm hoping that the cops may, would the police officers please do something about this? This is totally out of control.
Geez.
Totally out of control. Third degree, you can't condone this.
I mean, vicious power slam.
This is uncalled for. Now, look at Hungarian. Did they prove their point now? Wait, no, here comes Cronus is back up. Jeepers,
what's going on?
This will never end.
Oh!
Jeepers, oh. What in?
I don't know what's going on.
Third degree, I am speechless. Can we please, we got to get the fans away from the ring. We got to get some security in here to separate these individuals. Oh, they're still going at a double clothesline. I don't know. No one is trying to stop this mayhem. What a way to end Cage Terror 2 with the EWF. I'm at this point, I am totally speechless. I'm looking for security or somebody. No one from the locker room is even trying to stop this, but do you blame them? Look out! Look out! God! Oh no, John Cronus is back up again.
He's nuts?
Both these individuals are crazy. There goes Samoan Gangster, LA Smooth. Cronus is left in the ring. Uh-oh.
I don't want to be here.
Third degree, I think maybe it's time for us to leave. I think it's time for us to officially leave.
I think you're right.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Let's get out of Dodge while Dodge is still here.
You're right. I'm out of here.
This is crazy.
Can't believe this.
I don't know.
I'm hoping they can control that guy.
I'm not going in the back now.
No,
you?
No. I don't need my pay. I'll work for free. I don't want anywhere near the locker room.